everyone, welcome back to the ninZa.co YouTube channel. In trading, it's easy to get trapped by the market, especially when we rely too heavily on volume indicators without truly understanding the logic behind price movement. Take this example. At first glance, everything seems to signal a short opportunity, a strong, bearish candle accompanied by high volume. And right after that, the price suddenly shoots back up and you start doubting your entire trading strategy. Or in another scenario, the price then breaks below the most recent low with strong trading volume around that area. And once again, you confidently enter another sell position. At that moment, it feels like everything is working against us. So how can you protect yourself from these market traps, or better yet, avoid them entirely? What will actually help you trade with confidence and consistency so your results look like this? Your trades will be analyzed clearly and they will look like this. Today, we're going to take a closer look at a powerful new indicator, a tool that helps you detect market traps created by smart money or big players. This indicator is built upon the concept of iceberg orders, something you may have heard about before. But in this video, we'll break it down clearly so you can truly understand how to apply it in your trading. Now, let's dive straight into how this indicator generates its signals. First, the most visible thing on the chart is the repeated appearance of blue candles and pink candles. These are the initial signals used by the indicator to scan the market and detect whether buying pressure or selling pressure is currently dominating. The indicator is built on the logic of spotting unusual trading pressure. In the markets, every strong price move is driven by real money flow. It never happens by accident. There's always smart money or big players behind those movements. When you see a large blue candle or a cluster of multiple blue candles, it indicates strong buying pressure. This often suggests that institutional traders may be pushing the market upward. On the other hand, a strong pink candle or a series of consecutive pink candles reveals clear selling pressure, which could mean that big players are unloading their positions or manipulating price to trap retail traders. We call these candles pressure zones, areas on the chart that reveal strong buying or selling pressure. These zones are where big players leave their footprints in the market. But it doesn't stop there. After identifying candles with strong buying or selling pressure, the indicator goes a step further by analyzing the true intensity of that pressure across the entire candle cluster. Not just a single candle. It calculates how dominant the buying or selling force really is compared to the total traded volume within that pressure zone. This information is then visualized through a strength bar displayed above each pressure zone, helping you clearly see how strong the real force behind the move is. To be even more specific, each strength bar displays the total buy or sell volume within an entire pressure zone, rather than a single candle. In this example, the indicator detected three strong bearish candles in a row, signaling a clear selling pressure zone. Together, these candles generated a total sell volume of 249, indicating that sellers are clearly dominating the market at this point. In addition, each strength bar displays 10 energy dots. These dots act as a visual scale that represents the intensity of each pressure zone. The more dots that are filled, the stronger the buying or selling pressure in that zone. In this example, the strength bar shows 7 out of 10 energy dots, which means that selling pressure is clearly dominant within this bearish candle cluster. This indicates that sellers are aggressively pushing the price down inside this pressure zone. Similarly, on the opposite side, when there is strong buying pressure, the indicator will also show you exactly how much buying force is present within that candle cluster. The energy dots that represent buying pressure are displayed in blue. And in this example, you can see that the indicator shows 7 out of 10 energy dots, indicating that buyers are clearly dominant within this pressure zone. So how does the indicator actually detect where strong or unusual buying and selling pressure occurs? The answer lies in delta volume. It allows the indicator to detect unusual buying or selling pressure hidden behind the price action. However, some traders may ask, why use delta volume instead of level 2 or even level 3 data to detect market pressure? That's a great question and a very valid one. The reason is simple. When trading, institutions and smart money don't want to leave any traces of their true intentions. That's why they rarely expose themselves through DOM or level 2, level 3 data. because any trader can see that information. If you try to identify their moves solely by reading the DOM, you would need advanced order flow skills and deep experience, which is extremely difficult. However, there is one thing that big players cannot hide: executed orders. And that is exactly what Delta reveals. However, identifying Delta is only the first step. Since big players operate with large trading volume, pushing the price up or down is often just their initial move. Their true intention is not to create a trend immediately, but to generate liquidity, forcing the market to provide enough opposite orders so they can execute their real strategy behind the scene. To uncover the true intention behind price movements, we move to step two: identifying the ice zone. After detecting a pressure zone, a zone with strong buying or selling pressure, the indicator will then search for an ice zone. This is a critical price area where the indicator analyzes the real actions of smart money, revealing whether the previous move was genuine or just a liquidity trap. The indicator identifies an ice zone by detecting a sudden pause or slowdown in price movement after a strong and decisive bearish move. When price stops falling abruptly right after a heavy sell-off, it creates a logical contradiction. Because if sellers were truly in control, price should continue to drop. This abnormal price behavior signals that the real activity of the big players is beginning. At this stage, they are no longer pushing the price down. Instead, they are absorbing the remaining sell orders from the market to prepare for their true intention. At each ice zone, the indicator recalculates the true buying or selling pressure to give you additional confirmation before making a trading decision. In this example, the ice zone shows a selling pressure of 457. This number plays a very important role in identifying the behavior of smart money, and I will explain its meaning in more detail in the next section. And finally, we have the trading signal. If the price breaks above the ice zone, a buy signal is triggered. This reveals the true intention of the big players. They want to push the price higher after first creating selling pressure to generate liquidity, forcing retail traders to sell so they can accumulate their long positions before moving the market in the opposite direction. Similarly, in this case, the indicator detects a single bullish candle with extremely strong buy volume. Unlike the previous example, just one candle is already enough to form a pressure zone, which tells us that the buying pressure here is exceptionally strong and aggressive. In contrast, the earlier example required four consecutive bearish candles to create a selling pressure zone. This comparison clearly shows that the buying pressure in this scenario is significantly stronger than the previous selling pressure, which may indicate that smart money is entering the market at this point. Immediately after that, the indicator detected an ice zone, showing that the price suddenly paused right after a strong bullish candle. This indicates a high probability that the bullish candle was a fake move, often used to trap impatient buyers before reversing the market. After that, when the price breaks below the previously identified ice zone, a sell signal is triggered. This confirms that the real intention of the smart money has taken place. They pushed the price up earlier just to generate liquidity and then reverse the market in their true direction. As you can see, the signal mechanism of this indicator is simple, logical, and easy to follow. Everything is displayed visually on the chart, and once you understand how pressure zones, ice zones, and the iceberg signal work together, you'll be able to track smart money activity and limit market traps with confidence. If you have any thoughts, questions, or trading insights you'd like to share, feel free to drop a comment below. I'd love to hear from you. Next, let's explore how to use the Sonarlike Iceberg Finder effectively in your trading. Feature helps you filter ice zones more effectively by removing weak or noisy signals and keeping only the most meaningful ones. So, how does it work? In this example, you can see a pressure zone forming first, and shortly after, an ice zone appears within the same price range. When the range filter is enabled, this is considered a valid ice zone. The range filter simply prioritizes ice zones that overlap with the pressure zone. This doesn't mean that other ice zones are useless. It's just that an ice zone forming inside the pressure zone shows that the opposite market force enters very quickly and decisively. This is important because after creating initial pressure to generate liquidity, pressure zone, smart money reacts immediately in the opposite direction. Ice zone. This fast reversal reaction indicates strong intention and high commitment from big players. When smart money steps in that aggressively, it often leads to a higher probability of a successful reversal. So the range filter doesn't eliminate ice zones based on structure. It simply focuses on those with faster opposite pressure reaction, which statistically carry higher reliability. Similarly, in this example, the ice zone also forms inside the pressure zone, indicating that the opposite market force stepped in quickly and decisively. On the other hand, if you turn off the range filter, you'll notice that the pressure zone and ice zone no longer overlap and are often separated by a few candles. This means the ice zone may form later, after the price continues to move higher or lower beyond the initial pressure zone. With the range filter turned off, you will have more trading opportunities because the criteria for detecting ice zones become less strict. This allows you to accept ice zones that form later instead of requiring an immediate opposite reaction like when the range filter is enabled. Next, let's talk about the delta volume inside each ice zone, which I mentioned earlier. Reading it is very simple but extremely powerful when it comes to confirming signals. In this example, we first saw strong buying pressure pushing the price up. Shortly after that, an ice zone was formed, and the indicator detected a delta volume of 175 inside this zone. So what does this mean? Even though price just moved up strongly, the delta is negative, 175 inside the ice zone. This indicates that selling pressure has immediately stepped back in, meaning sellers are absorbing the remaining buy orders in the market. This is a strong sign that the previous bullish move may have been a liquidity push or fake move. And if a sell signal appears next, it becomes much more reliable thanks to delta confirmation. Similarly, in this example, even though the delta volume inside the ice zone is relatively small, it still indicates that selling pressure is present in this area. This means sellers are stepping back into the market, which strengthens the sell signal if it appears afterward. In contrast, in this example, the ice zone forms after a bullish move, but the delta volume is positive. This means that selling pressure inside this ice zone is still weak and sellers are not fully stepping in yet. Therefore, a sell signal in this situation is less reliable compared to previous examples. If you still decide to enter a sell trade here, it's better to use a smaller take profit target and tighter risk management to minimize potential losses since the setup is not strongly supported by delta confirmation. Join the HelloWin Forum, where ninZa family traders come together to explore valuable trading knowledge and products. Click the link in the description to get started. Thanks for watching until the end. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, and ring the bell icon so you don't miss our latest content.